Welcome back, Tubal Views. Today I've got a ski boat, older ski boat. It's a Mastercraft, and what you'll see is that it's a little bit chalked out, specifically on the top side. Definitely in the hull, but definitely on the top side. And you can see that they've used mailbox letters as hull registration numbers, which, you know, to each their own, right? You'll also notice there's some transfers or some white marks in the black rub rail or gunwale, depending on what you call it, depending on the region that you're in. So I'll be showing you briefly how I get those cleaned up a little bit. The aluminum on the top and the bottom will be cleaned up primarily through the compounding that I do while I'm working around this boat. But the black, where it's got the transfer marks from hitting something made of plastic or maybe other boats' Gelcoat, that's not terribly difficult to get rid of. So I'll show you that in a little bit. Right now I'm just going to walk around the boat, give you an idea of what it looked like before I finished so that you have some sort of a barometer of what it takes, what I've done, how long it took, and if your boat looks like this, you'll have a pretty good idea. So first things first, I'm going to take off the decals and the vents and all the hardware on the boat that I possibly can. I'll be masking off all the black trim that I don't want to get destroyed with compound. And in this case, I'm using a denatured razor blade, just means that it's not going to cut you, and some acetone to remove the adhesive. And here we go. This is a transfer mark, a nice big one on the side of this guy's boat. And what I'm going to do is just grab a white terry cloth towel and some acetone. And I apologize, I'm going to spill a little bit of this, but I'm doing it one-handed. I typically don't. So spilling, it's not common for me. But whatever, it's boats. You got to break some eggs to make an omelet, right? Anyway, just basically rub it back and forth. The acetone dissolves the plastic and the rubber and leaves you with a nice black finish. Now, if you want, you can come back over this with some 303 aerospace protectant or some vinyl or rubber trim protectant, and that'll keep it black for a little bit longer.
All right, so I'm going to try to get into this little corner area here, try to blend the two colors. I'm also probably going to destroy this pinstripe. I didn't start off thinking that, but that's probably what's going to happen. So instead of using heavy cut or perfected EXAC, I'm just going to stop dealing with the subtle tactics, throw a little super duty in there, grab a wool pad, and start going. Starting off kind of slow because nobody needs to go super fast right here. At least not until it's all spread out. And once it's spread out, then I can speed up a little bit. So, while the overall gloss is coming back pretty quick, the color isn't quite matching. You probably only see it from here, maybe. So I got a little bit more work to go to get that color to match.
Now you might notice while I'm working this wheel back and forth, I'm at a fairly aggressive angle, almost 45 degrees, sometimes even more steep than that. The reason for that is this boat has two 90 degree angles, one right above the gunwale and one right after that, about a, I don't know, centimeter above that. And if you've ever seen a boat that was older, that got detailed maybe a year or 2 years ago, where it starts to fade out first is going to be in these little corners, mostly because detailers don't spend a lot of time there. As soon as they get a color that they think is acceptable, they move on. I'm trying to get out all of the oxidation I possibly can so that this boat doesn't fade out in that particular way. And to do that, you'll see me not only go at that really steep angle, but then you'll see me do a little bit of a cross cut. I'll change the angle of the buffer ever so slightly, going in one direction with a slightly different angle than I did the other direction. So as I move forward, I might tip it one direction about 5 degrees extra, and then when I go back the other direction, I might tip it 5 degrees in the opposite direction. This to me allows me to do a cross-cutting pattern or situation on this little spot, and it's a little bit of a way that I can get slightly more aggressive than just going over it with a buffer at the same angle and the same speed with the same pressure. I can do a lot more work doing a little bit of a cross cut than I can just keeping the same uniform pattern the entire way through. And here I'll employ a different technique to get these small edges on the side of this red stripe. So I'll lay out a little bit of product and I'll work my wheel up and down, rolling into the product so I get the most efficient use out of it. But I'm just basically going up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. And I'm moving towards the stern of the boat very, very slightly. Maybe, I don't know, a millimeter each up and a millimeter each down. And as soon as I get to the end of this product line, whatever residual product is still left on the boat, I'll work that the way you saw me do it just prior. Always changing it up. If this is going to work better, I'll know. If it's not going to work as well, I'll know. But it's good to change things up and try different stuff.
So the hard parts to get are right above this aluminum piece right here, right in that corner, and then right up here in this corner. Those are the two hard spots to get, and you can see how small they are as soon as the camera focuses, because it's a stupid phone. There we go. Anyway, so what I try to do is just use the edge of the buffer primarily, and you can see it's all red. And just get down into these little corners as best I can. Still got a ways to go. And once I get the red done, I'll start working on the white, and then I'll work on the top, blend the two together. Should look really nice. So using the Super Duty instead of Heavy Cut or Perfect It in the initial pass, you're wondering why maybe I didn't start off with something lighter. A lot of people always say go with the lightest thing first and then work your way up to the heavy stuff, because you don't want to take off too much gel coat. I had a couple things that I was working with. One, I've got places where these decals were removed, so I'm gonna have to blend the oxidized gel coat with the shiny gel coat underneath that. That, and I knew that I was gonna have to get fairly aggressive in the corners above the rub rail and right above that where it dips in a little bit. Has kind of a contoured, concave shape. So another reason I used Super Duty right off the bat is because older Mastercrafts, anything from like 1990, actually probably 1997 on back, generally have really hard gel coat, and you have to get fairly aggressive with it to get any of the oxidation out. So instead of playing around with Heavy Cut and Perfect It, I just figured I'd start off strong and then work my way down. So that's what I've done here. The next step is going to be to use a little bit of Heavy Cut. That'll clean up the white, I'm pretty sure. If not, I can always resort back to Super Duty if I need it. But for right now, I'm happy with the red. I'm happy with the gloss and the color. I think I'm done with that. I'll move on to the Heavy Cut now. We can take a look at that. I get in trouble for this a lot. So since I used Super Duty, which is a really gritty, aggressive compound, you can see all the dust that's kind of settled up here on the top. I'm gonna go ahead and spur out my pad, even though I personally don't think that Heavy Cut's gonna really get ruined by using Super Duty first, but I'll do it because it's a good practice. So. Shake up the old Heavy Cut, and we'll start back here. Let's see, what are you looking at? Let's start right back here where you saw me start before. And again, I'm gonna work on this red a little bit, and I'll work on that first. After I do that, then I'll work on this top piece, blend them together, see how that goes. But everything's pretty much the same. Just working a little bit less now because the Super Duty's done most of the hard work. So this is mostly just cleaning up all the scratchy scratch marks from the Super Duty. And it's starting to put a little gloss on the red down here by the gunnel. That looks pretty good. All right, so let's work on this top piece here. Okay, so there's a little lip right under here. I'm gonna focus some of the buffer's energy on that specifically. Try to get that shiny before everything else. Okay, so I'm getting a little bit of a gloss. You might not be able to see it, but the color from where the decals were, that's still fairly prominent. So I'm gonna finish this out with the heavy cut, but I might come back with a little super duty to try to grind out some of that discoloration where the decals were. Might, we'll see. We'll see how it goes. now it's just inspect, see what it looks like. I can already tell that the color from the decal here, 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 and then there was a couple more here, I can see the difference in color. I'm not sure if you can on the camera. You'll just have to take my word for it. I don't necessarily like it. At the same time, it does have a nice shine. And I don't see a difference where the oxidation was thicker because the decal wasn't there, or less result from the heavy cut where the decal was. So I might just let this stand, and there's a couple reasons for that. One, I'm super lazy. Two, you could just park this boat out in the sun for a while and see if these colors even out. And sometimes they actually do. And three, the owner of this boat's gonna have to get some either A, new pinstripe to fix this, or B, new hull registration numbers, in which case it'll break up this discoloration. And you probably won't even notice it. And when the overall boat looks really shiny and glossy, it's one of those things that it would take you a while and you'd have to know what to look for to see it. So I might absolutely just leave this as is and continue on. In fact, I think that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna continue up with a little bit of heavy cut. Another thing I'd like to point out, you may have noticed, because the wheel has a little pink to it while I was working on the top, some of this color got jammed up, mixed in the compound, and it laid up on the gel coat. It didn't stain the gel coat. In fact, there's a little bit up here and you can see it just wipes off. As long as the gel coat's in fairly good shape and you're getting down to the shiny part of the gel coat, stuff doesn't like to impart into it. Now, if it was really oxidized and my pad was pink and it had some color in it and I touched it, yeah, you're gonna get some transfer of color. But as soon as you grind off that oxidation that's holding that pigment, it's gone. At least generally, it's gone. 99% of the time, it's gone. You don't necessarily have to worry about it. If it does seem like it's bleeding in, then you just tape off your colored section, compound that, wax it, and then tape that off, compound the white, and wax it. Not looking terrible. Again, this is in the shade, so it's not in direct sunlight, but I get a good sense that it's a decent reflection. That being finished, I'm not going to use Perfect It just yet. I'm going to work on this top, see if I can get that looking really good, and then when I get to the point of perfecting that, that's when I'll drop down and perfect the sides. So let's get into this, but I'm not obviously going to hit it with Perfect It first. I'm probably going to start with some heavy cut. And for that, I will set you right here, maybe a little bit higher. And I'll tell you what, I'll show you one of my favorite ways to clean off a boat. So you see all this dust and stuff on top of the boat. I'm going to spin my buffer up. Ta-da! Okay, so I'm going to use a little heavy cut. No need to spur out the pad because I was just using heavy cut. Spreading, cross-cutting, flattening, okay? Spreading. might be able to tell the difference between what was done and what wasn't. Again, what was done and what wasn't. Heavy Cut seems to be doing a pretty good job. Let's put a nice gloss on this. And what I'm looking for, so if I hold my buffer up here, see if I can make this work. Maybe you can see the reflection of the buffer. In this type of light, I'm looking for detail in the buffer. I'm looking for color in the buffer. If I can see those things, I think I'm doing pretty good. And also knowing that I'm going to come back over this with perfected EXAC tells me that as long as I've got a fairly decent shine here, it should be okay. Now there's a little bit of smagma that was kicked up down here, just because as the pad comes over, it departs some compound in there before that dries up. I'm just going to try to clean that up a little bit. Smooth it out. And work from here down. So that's where we're going next. Getting there. Now we come to the tricky part, detail section. Let's get into that. Now you may notice right around here there's a little dust and dirt. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm using heavy cut, for God's sakes. It's gritty, just like dust. But it finishes a little bit better than dust. So, I'm going to treat this nose piece like it's all one big section. Generally, I like to do one half of a boat and then the other half. In this case, when I get up to the front, I'm kind of going to work it all as one piece just so I'm not drawing a line straight down the middle of all this. I'm just going to work it. It just saves me time and it's one less thing I have to worry about. But the process is generally the same. Spread it out. Try to cross cut as much as you can. Where you can't, don't worry about it. But if you can, try. And I put a little extra lubrication on the dust just so it's easier to pull out. And if we rock you back and forth, maybe you can see the shine, the reflection, and then boop, it all goes away. So now I start on the other side of the bow. And I'll work everything pretty much the same. I'll start working on the red stripe here first, then I'll work on this white. Then I'll come up here, come back and forth, making sure to blend this section together. And then when I get right about here, I'll just close it off. Blend these two sections together. Don't have to worry about all this getting in the way. So that's what I'll work on next. The next thing I'll show you, I'm not exactly sure. Maybe when this is in the sun, because the sun is coming over this way pretty quickly. All right, moving on. Now maybe you can tell how bad the oxidation is here and why it's kind of difficult to get to with the two angles there. And then you can see where the decals were, there's a reflection. Where the decals weren't, like here, no reflection. Here, no reflection. So this is what we're going to try to blend together and get looking pretty much the same. I won't show you this because I already showed it to you, but now you'll have a little bit of a gauge as to what it looked like before, so that when I'm done, I can show it to you and you guys can be super impressed. Like always, JK. All right, I'm gonna put you back on pause, finish up this top. So I've got all the super duty and heavy cut on the bow done. I'm just now kind of inspecting it, making sure I like what I see. So far, so good. Now, once I've wiped all this off, I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with some perfected EXAC, going through the exact same motions I did before. So I'm gonna leave the camera right here where it's at. I'm gonna turn it off. Once I'm done with this top section, I'll turn it back on. You may or may not be able to see a difference in the reflection. I'm not entirely sure. But overall, it should bump it up a notch. And once that's done, then we'll clean it, maybe put a little polish on there. I'm probably going to use, after going through this much work, I'm probably going to use Fire Glaze by Restructure Marine on the white from this line up. Down here, because it was so dry and so oxidized for so long, I might actually use a little bit of Flagship by Meguiar's just to wet it up, put a little bit more oil in that gel coat so that it doesn't turn so quickly. If this was a boat that I had all the time in the world to go through, we'd be removing the pinstripe altogether just to replace it, and I'd probably go an extra one or two more times with heavy cut on the red specifically, just to get down deep into the gel coat. At that point, I might just use Flagship on the hull, and on the top side, even the red, I might use Fire Glaze Plus. In this instance, I'm not going to do that. I'll use Fire Glaze Plus above the red on the white where it'll last the longest, and everywhere else, it'll probably get Meguiar's Flagship. All right, so let's see. Turn you in a little bit. Okay, so this should be the very next scene that you guys see. I won't move the camera. We'll just see if it looks a little bit better. Okay, I'm not entirely sure if you can tell if there's a difference. And now it's time to wipe it off with some rubbing alcohol or some window cleaner and apply a little bit of the Fire Glaze Plus just to lock this in. So I'll tell you what, I'll go grab that stuff, do that. Maybe I'll show it to you. Maybe. Thank you.
Now, this being the first application of fire glaze, plus it's a dry pad, so I gotta put a little bit more on there than I would if I was working, say, I don't know, 3 or 4 feet down further on the boat. And with fire glaze, you just wanna work it in really, really well. So what you're gonna see is a lot of repetitive motion. I'm going to be using this pad to force these little nanotech particles all over the surface of the boat, trying to make sure that they're filling the pores of the gel coat. And then I'm touching every square inch of this boat, or at least the white section. Remember, I'm going to use Fire Glaze Plus on the white, and I'll use Meguiar's flagship on the red. Not that the red might not be able to benefit from the Fire Glaze. I just think that because it was so dry, it needs some of the oils from the Meguiar's flagship. And so that's what my thought process is. I know that the Fire Glaze is going to do a really good job on this white, so might as well use its strength where it's going to be most productive.
Evento, tiempo de manejar Chevy del Labor Day en tus concesionarios Chevy del sur de California, donde llegan nuevos modelos diariamente y los compradores bien calificados no pagan por 90 días. Además, obtén bajas tasas de financiamiento en una Silverado 1500 2022. Apresúrate a tu concesionario Chevy del sur de California. Los cargos de financiamiento se acumulan desde la fecha del financiamiento. Debes financiar con GM Financial. Algunos clientes podrían no calificar. Primero va a entregar con un adelanto del 8.32. Llama a Chevy para tu 400 Chevy o visita www.chevy.com.
Extra Man here at Extra Mile with another extra thought. You and I know a convenience store with extra is all about getting what you want when you want it. Like hot and fresh food, mile one coffee, and fizz fountain drinks. And why not go extra convenient by getting what you want delivered? Get your go-tos right to your door, right from your smartphone and your favorite delivery app. Boom! Treat you right. It's now just a tap away. Extra Mile convenience stores at select Chevron and PepsiCo locations.
Telling anybody I did this, but I might have painted his vents because they were pretty trashed out. So tomorrow I'll work on the rest of this top side, starting from here, working my way back, and then I'll get into the hull. And that's probably one of the things that you guys want to see. And I mean, whatever I was doing on top is the same as I'm going to do on the bottom, but for some reason people have a harder time dealing with the oxidation in the hull, mostly because they do it or their detailer does it while it's in the water, and they don't have enough elbow/shoulder to throw into it to really get the oxidation out. This boat's going to be a little bit of a challenge here getting over the fender hump, specifically because this trailer doesn't have a gap in it, so I'm going to have to lift it up from back here or somewhere up under the word Mastercraft. But if I can get it up, then I can do a fairly nice job around that fender. So we'll get into that tomorrow. I'm probably going to post this specifically because I haven't posted anything for a while. And somebody asked me about that gunnel rub rail thing, so maybe I'll show them that. Anyway, that's the only sun I got. Apologize. But I think it's looking pretty good. All right, tomorrow, lots more of this. Thanks for stopping by. Turns out that the hull of this boat really didn't take all that much. The red took a little bit of Super Duty just to get the pink out, and then a little heavy cut perfect it, and that's pretty much it. One thing I would like to point out, if you're ever doing a boat with a trailer like this, grab a jack so you can lift the boat up to do around where the fender well was on the trailer. That way, when you're doing a full restoration or something like that, or really trying to get the Gelcoat dialed in, you can actually get the Gelcoat dialed in. You don't have a little spot down there that's a little bit dull. So I just wanted to show you, I know this is in the shade, but to judge the clarity, I try to make sure I can see detail in the reflection, like reading the labels of the bottles from 15 feet away. That's usually a pretty good indicator that it's about where it needs to be. I've got a little bit left to go on this. Shouldn't take that long. Now, I know I didn't show you all that much on the hull, but quite honestly, I've got 300 plus videos over there in the playlist you can look through to see how to do a hull. It wasn't anything special. A little bit of Super Duty, like I said, on the red, and then some heavy cut and some perfected EXAC. After that, strip it and put some polish on it. That's it, obviously, because we're at the black screen. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, ask a question, hit me up in the comments.